Srila Narayana Goswami Maharaj said two disciplines. Two disciplines. One is happening in January, and then again it will happen in December. The most of us actually took birth here. My Gurudev had three birth plans: Harinam, Chaitanyamur, jail. Diksha, this initiation was in the jail of Krishnanagar, and Sannyas, he took it here. No. Harijan Maharaj will speak now. Careful. Hey. Maharaj. After that, Madhya Siksha Guru and Sannyas Guru also, Chagat Guru, Tula Pushtang, Vishnupada, Ashtatra Sasa, Madhya Bhakti Vedanta, Narayan Goswami Maharaj, paying my obeisances, millions of obeisances to his lotus feet. After that, our Param Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Pragyan, Keshava Goswami Maharaj, Gurudev is to say that this is my birthplace. It's called Aturghar. It's some kind of saying in Bengali. During the Navadvip Parikrama, until the distribution finishes, like prasad distribution. Param Gurudev always to sit there by the jackfruit. Once what happened, there's the god brother of Param Gurudev, they came. Param Gurudev used to love that bird. Param Gurudev had three pillars. We just heard from Bhaktivinoda Bhavan Goswami Maharaj, Bhaktivinoda Narayan Goswami Maharaj, Bhaktivinoda Trivikram Maharaj, Trivikram Maharaj. When we came to the temple, Navin Krishna Prabhu, Sudarna Prabhu, me, Srila Bhaktivinoda Narayana Goswami Maharaj used to teach us Upadeshamrita. Everybody, they're scared of studying in school, they came to temple. 5 a.m. they used to teach us, he used to teach us like that. Srila Madhusudana Maharaj. Madhusudana Maharaj is the mother of the Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti. How he served Gurudev, The example is seen by all the Vaishnava Gaon, especially Bhanu Maharaj just said that now. Guru Maharaj one time could not come to Navadvip Parikrama. He was sick. And Gopikanta Brahmachari Janardana Maharaj was with him. He wrote to Srila Narayana Goswami Maharaj. Gurudev actually, Srila Bhakti Narayana Goswami Maharaj wrote the letter to Srila Bhakti Goswami Maharaj that you must come here. He was not inviting. This is your Guru Seva, you must come here. This is how we are going to hear so much more glorification from other Vaishnavas. I'm going to finish here. Bhagavan Maharaj was saying that by coal we are making the cow dung. Krishnadas Prabhu was very expert in kirtan. When he came to this temple, he was very skinny and also black. The coal came from outside, we have to carry it. That time Nikunja Prabhu was there, Goswami Maharaj. Krishnadas Prabhu said that I am already too black, and you know, if I carry coal, I'll be more black. Then Gurudev said, it's okay, no problem, you don't have to carry coal so you can become black. You don't have to become black. And also told you have to eat so much more kheer, then you can become fair, like white color. Guru Maharaj never liked anybody insulting Vaishnavism. When Gurudev started preaching outside Western country, Guru Maharaj was preaching, giving Harikatha here. One sannyasi from ISKCON came telling to Guru Maharaj, your Narayan Maharaj is going to Western countries and destroying our preaching field. The more he insults, and so Bhavana Goswami Maharaj keeps saying, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Guru Maharaj keep thinking that when this person will go away. Then Guru Maharaj says, I don't understand anything. He can go to my guardians. Guardian is the guardian. Secretary is there. Where is he? Krishna Kapapa Madhusudana Maharaj, he was brooming outside by the jackfruit trees, wearing a gamcha only. He thinking that he's maybe servant. He asked, oh, where is your secretary? He is giving Harikatha in Natya Mandir. He's a mother of this temple, he's wearing gamcha, he thinks that he's a servant, but he doesn't know that he's a mother of this temple. He came and see that the secretary is Bhaktivinoda Narayan Goswami Maharaj, then he had to like fold his hand and go away. This is the place. I'm requesting Sridhar Maharaj to speak in Hindi.
Very good part of the So the place where we have come while doing this parikrama, so we have heard that Srila Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj, so initially he established this mark. So Maharaj, he was very great philosopher, and he was a very intelligent person. He was a great scholar. His every activity, it was always different, and it was always aiming for different goals. He named this math as Devanand Gaudiya Math. Why he named this math as Devanand Gaudiya Math? Because it is related to Devanand Pandit. Devanand Pandit, he was a great scholar. He used to speak on various scriptures. And he used to speak on Vedanta also. And what is Bhagavatam? The every word of Bhagavatam, it is completely filled with love. And Srivas Pandit, after hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, the verses like
वैजयंती चमाला रंधान वेणुरधर सुधया पुरयान गोप वृंदये वृंदारण्यम स्वपद रमणम प्राविशस्तात गीत कीर्ति लजिस श्लोक सुनकर
After hearing this verse, Shrivas Pandit, he completely absorbed in love, and the Ashtasatvik Bhav, they just came in his body, and Devanand Pandit, he just said, why he is behaving like this? So nobody spoke anything, but Mahaprabhu, he knew everything, he is omniscient. So he came over there and he just tore the Srimad Bhagavatam book, because Mahaprabhu was very angry that even you are reading Srimad Bhagavatam, but still you don't know the inner meaning of Bhagavatam, so there is no use of speaking on such book. So he tore his Bhagavatam book, and he just, and we can even see that the main temple made by him, made by Srila Param Gurudev, you can just see the gate, the name of gate is Narhari God. So who is Narhari? He is one of the dearmost servants of Srila Prabhupada. So if someone wants to enter into Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavad Bhakti, then what he has to do? So until and unless you don't have the mercy of Srila Gurudev, you are not serving Gurudev, you cannot enter in the realm of Bhakti. So that's why it is said. So that's why he named the gate as Narhari Dwar, Narhari Gate, and what he has written on that, he has written, so by taking the Sharanagati of Srila Gurudev only and chanting this Maha Mantra, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, and by taking the shelter of Sri Harinam, so, and there is one more other gate. Why? He is made in Madan Mohan Tarun. Why? So it is said that if you have taken the shelter of Harinam by the mercy of Srila Gurudev, so what is the destination of Jeeva? What is destination of Jeeva? So that's why the Jiva, like gopis, they are singing the gopi geet. So Krishna, he appeared as the in the Manmath form. So the last destination of Jiva is, so it is Rasa Mandal. So there is one place, it is the pressing printing press, and they have named it as Vaikuntha Vartha. So what is this printing press? This printing press is the place where the discussions from Vaikuntha are being printed, and the Natya Mandir, it is named as Seva. Just see the, so we can see all the four Vaishnava Acharyas over here has been, the duties have been established over here. So we, until unless we are not taking the shelter of Vaishnava Sampradaya, we cannot enter into the realm of bhakti. So you can see there is one, the symbol of flute over here. Like Krishna, he just called all the Braj gopis by playing his flute. So in the same way, he has made the Bansuri. So he has named the Gaushala as Gobardhan. And there is one more speciality, that the place which is this washroom. So washroom has been named as Kyan Khand. Gyan, the Nirvishesh Bhavma Gyan. He, what he is, because it is Nirgun, there is nothing, it can give nothing, so it is just like stool. So you should not take it. So the temple established by him is so beautiful and so philosophical, and his name is Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj. So his name only indicates that he will establish a special thing. What is the meaning of Bhakti Pragyan? He's not just Gyan, he is Pragyan. What does mean Pragyan? That's why when Brahma was being given the Divya Gyan by Bhagavan, so what is Param Guru? Param Guru is a super secret knowledge which has been given. What is that super secret knowledge? It is Krishna with Srimati Radhika, but it is still not Pragyan. So what is the secret? What is the rahasya? What is the bhakti? It is bhakti. So when one, because Krishna, he is beautiful, but he is still incomplete, and he becomes complete with Srimati Radhika only. So what is the meaning of Pragyan? What is the speciality of Pragyan? When Radha and Krishna, they are in the assembly of the Manjaris, Rupa Manjari and other Manjaris. So that is Pragyan. So you can see all the sannyasis have been given as title as Bhakti Vedanta, because other people from other maths, they were saying that why you are giving title as Bhakti Vedanta? What is this Bhakti Vedanta? Bhakti Vedanta, Bhakti Vedanta. So what is this names we are giving? What is this Vedanta? So Srila Param Gurudev said, what is the meaning of Vedanta? It is the essence, it is the end of Vedanta. So what is the destination of Vedanta? What is the essence of Vedanta? It is Srimad Bhagavatam. So Bhagavatam is the fruit of all the scriptures. And what is the fruit of essence of Bhagavatam? It is the 10th canto. And what is the essence of 10th canto? It is the Gopi Geet, where Krishna, he himself is saying that I'm totally indebted to the gopis, and I can never repay to them. So when Krishna, he saw the So this gopi, Srimati Radhika, she served Krishna in such a way that Krishna is always surrendered to her. Because some few people, they used to even joke that why you have made white Krishna, because white marble is cheaper than the black stone. So that's why Srila Param Gurudev, he just explained this philosophy, why the Krishna is white, because Krishna is completely absorbed in the mood of Srimati Radhika, and is completely absorbed in Srimati Radhika's mood. And so these three vigrish, the three deities, are actually symbolizing the Unnat Ujjwal Ras. So you can just see this temple, then you can see how beautifully he has made it, and how the philosophical names he has given. So beautifully he has shown his intelligence while establishing this mat. So that's why we have come to this mat. We will take the Ashirvad of Srila Bhakti Pragyan Kishore Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Pragyan, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Vaman Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Bhakti Vikram Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Vayan Goswami Maharaj. We all may all be blessed by them. I also used to come. So I used to come over here and sleep in the room of Van Maharaj and of Srila Van. So all the senior sannyasis, they have given a lot of love to us, because until unless you don't surrender to Vaishnavas, you cannot enter into bhakti. So you have to have their blessings and mercy. So like we are doing this Navdeep Parikrama, and we just pray to them that our Navdeep Parikrama, it just gives us the ultimate fruit, and you enter into the Braj Rasik Bha mood. Hare Krishna. So now we have to, very soon we'll go for the Sankalp. So we have heard too many speakers. So at this place, Srila Bhakti Pragyan Kishore Goswami Maharaj, Param Gurudev, he named the mat as Devanand Govindam. So by my material mind, whatever I can just I'm just giving some reasons just by a, so there are many other reasons. So when Krishna, he just called all the gopis by playing his flute, and then when he called them and he told them, oh, you go back. So and so Krishna is saying, so I'm not going into deep into the explanation of this verse. So Param Gurudev, he is giving that there is one. So the gate name is Narhari Tarun. So Narhari, he is one of the dearmost god brothers of Srila Param. He was the mother of Sri Chaitanya Mat. And so Narhari means Narsingdev also. So his name also, so that's why he is named Narhari, the gate. So Narhari is Narsingdev also. And the name of the gate, Madan Mohan. So like the son of a lion is lion only. So why then gate is named as Madan Mohan? So the two meanings which I heard from Gurudev is, so the until and unless you don't have the relationship, you will not be able to enter into bhajan. So Madan Mohan is the deity of relationship, the sambandh, the gyan. So that's why the gate is named as sambandh, as Madan Mohan. So Gurudev's one of the Gurudev's one of the disciples was Singhania Prabhu, and his garden name was Madan Mohan. So he named that gate after him. So who is Param Gurudev? Which Manjari he is? He is Vinod Manjari. What is the meaning of Vidit? Vinod. So it is by the special moods she is pleasing Srimati Radhika and Krishna. So Sri Chaitanya Dev. So, Vinod Sushila Param Gurudev, he is giving Anand to the Dev. Who is the Dev? Dev is Sriman Mahaprabhu. So, he is pleasing Sriman Mahaprabhu by his services. That's why the name of the place is Devanand. So, because who is the worshipful deity of Gaudiyas? That is Srimati Radhika. So, there is our very closest relationship is with Srimati Radhika. So, now we are going to pray to Srila Vyasadeva. So, what Vyasadeva is saying? So, so who is Dev? Dev is Krishna and Anand is Srimati Radhika. So everyone has gone to Barsana. So it is written Ladali Maharaj. Our Gurudev also went over there, but nobody opposed it. So why? Because Srimati Radha, because Maharaj is of male gender, addressing male gender, but Maharaj over here, Srimati Radhika is addressed as Maharaj. So it is Chaitanya Dev, Krishna Dev, and Radhika Dev. So that's why our Param Gurudev is giving Anand. He's pleasing to all these three, Sriman Mahaprabhu, Krishna, and Srimati Radhika. So, who is the worshipful deity of Srimati? It is Srimati Radhika, the worshipful deity of Gaudiya Math. So, Srimati Radhika, every day she's going to Nanda Bhavan every day from Yavat to cook for Sri Krishna. So what she is doing, so sometimes she is cooking in Yavat and she gives that food stuff and it is being transported, it is given to some Manjari and they take it to Nand Bhavan. So Srimati Radhika, so Manjari is laughing and Radhika is asking, why you are laughing? So what is the reason you are laughing? They say that no, I am not, because if somebody has know something, some joke or something, then they will laugh. So Srimati Radhika asks, if somebody is mad, then he will laugh. And if you know something or some reason to laugh, then you will laugh. So what is the reason? If you are not mad, just tell me. So so what is the philosophy of Vedant? What is the essence of Vedant? It is same. So I'm not going into the Vedant Sutra. So the Manjari is saying, or Srimati Radhika, you just listen. So I have seen one thing. So and where have you lived? So I have seen in the house of Nanda Maharaj that I have seen that one who is the essence, who is the topic of Vedanta Sutra. So what? So he is coming in the Gaudhuli. Gaudhuli is the mud which is when it is in the air, when the cows are walking. So in that muddy air he is walking and he is... So Param Gurudev is saying that's why he is giving the Bhaktivedan title, because what is the Vedanta? Vedanta, who knows the actual topic of Vedanta Sutra. So who is the topic of Vedanta Sutra? It is Krishna only. So why Gurudev was given the name as Vaman? So what is the meaning of Vaman? So all the Guru Vargas, they are in the mood of Vamyabhav. So Vaman. So Vaman. Va means a beautiful man, beautiful mind. So So that's why they said, oh gopis, his name is Vaman, that yes, you have this Vaman mood, that's why he's given as this name as Vaman. And why Narayan Maharaj was given name as Narayan, because Narayan, it means giving shelter to everyone. So Gurudev, he gave the shelter to everyone who came to this mud. And Trivikram, who was all powerful, and who was so that's why. So the two inventions of Srila Prabhupada. So Srila Gurudev gave sannyas to Srila Vamana Goswami, Srila Trivikram Goswami, Srila Narayan Goswami. So just before the sannyas of Swami Maharaj, So the sannyas of all the three Guru Bhais happened over here. So if Param Gurudev wouldn't have given sannyas to Srila Trivikram Maharaj, Srila Narayan Maharaj, and Srila Vamana Goswami Maharaj, then what will happen? So this movement of Krishna consciousness would have never spread. You can just see that the seed of this ISKCON has been laid by Srila Param Gurudev only. So Gurudev used to say that, oh, give this Gaudiya Kanthar to Naveen. So I said that, and he said that you can just leave one. So he gave so many names from N, because the name of sannyasis are given from 108 names. So Gurudev, he said that oh, there is one name as Nagna. Nagna means naked. You can give me that name. So I said to Gurudev, so how we can know about the tree by its fruit? So if you are named me as Nagna Maharaj, that I will not get clothes, so you will save the money for buying.
আমাদের যখন এখান থেকে আমরা গেলাম, গুরুদেব তীর্থময় বলছেন, তীর্থ মহারাজ 200 লোক আনতে পারবে, বলছে গুরুদেব 200 কি কমসে 2000 লোক নিয়ে আসবা, তো কৃপা আছে আপনার। এখন যে আমাদের এত ভিক্ষার চাপ হয়, মেন অবদান ওনার। আর উনি কি করলেন, যখন এত লোক এসেছে কত প্রসন্ন হয়েছেন, চোখে সবচেয়ে জল পড়ছে আমার সামনে, আমি দেখেছি কেউ আয়ুবনেস, আমি আয়ুবনেস। এখন উনি আমাদের মধ্যে নাই, উনি আমাদের কৃপা করুন।